we have already completed the define phase. In Six Sigma, as you already know, we follow five-phase methodology, DMAIC, define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. We have already completed the define phase. We are now into measure phase. What are the activities to be performed in measure phase? Before we go into that, let us understand that we use an equation called Y is equal to function of X in Six Sigma, where Y is the problem that we are trying to solve or effect. We also call Y as our CTQ, critical to quality parameter. Let us understand this with an example. Let us take an example of a hospital. A hospital is facing a problem. Their waiting time for the patient in the OPD is more. And as a result of this, there is a lot of customer dissatisfaction. And they want to improve this particular performance. Now, in the define phase, what we will do is we will define Y, or we will define CTQ, critical to quality parameter. In this particular example, what is Y or CTQ? Our Y or CTQ is nothing but our waiting time for the patient in minutes or in hours. Usually we take minutes. Now here, what we do in the define phase is we define the problem. What do we mean by waiting time? Are we talking about the waiting time for a particular zone, morning, afternoon, or evening? Are we talking about waiting time for a particular process during the OPD? So we have to define all these things in order to go ahead. All these activities are done in the define phase. In the measure phase, our major activity is to define the baseline. We must know where we are. What is the current level of the performance? What is the current waiting time? Let us assume that the waiting time ranges from 10 minutes to 60 minutes. How do you say what is the baseline? You cannot simply say this is average of both these readings. So in order to derive the baseline, you have to perform some of the analysis. That is what we learn in the measure phase. Now let us take an example. If you want to measure the waiting time, first the question is, do you have data already available or you have to collect the fresh data? If you already have the data, you can go ahead. But if you don't have the data, then first activity is to plan for data collection and then collect the data. We use various tools and techniques for even collecting the data and planning the data collection. Let us assume you already have a data. Then the next question comes is, can we rely on this data? Is this data authenticate? Can we straight away perform the analysis? If no, then we have to perform some analysis called measurement system analysis, or MSA, where we identify whether this data can be relied upon or not, and then we go ahead. In Six Sigma, we cannot straight away jump. We have to perform analysis at various stages. Now let us assume the data is authenticate. We have already performed the measurement system analysis. Then the next question is, what is the baseline? So in order to determine the baseline, we perform different charts and graphs. For example, we prepare control charts and decide and see how the data is behaving. Is there any outlier? Is there any sporadic problem in this particular data, or can we straight away take the mean of this data as our baseline? Once we do that, then we also decide what is the process capability. As you all know, in Six Sigma, we measure the process capability in terms of sigma level or Z score. Many times we also use CP or CPK. These are different methods that we use in Six Sigma to determine the process capability. So in the measure phase, once we perform all these activities, only then we go ahead. So our major activity is to define the baseline of the problem. Deliverables in the measure phase will be, number one, result of MSA or measurement system analysis if we have performed any. Number two, various control charts to see the pattern of the data. Process capability analysis like sigma level, CP or CPK. So these are all the deliverables at the end of the measure phase. Welcome to the measure phase.